fuzzy set, fuzzy logic, and fuzzy system. Now start with the fuzzy logic, right? So today we cover fuzzy system, set theory, what is fuzzy logic, why use fuzzy, theory of fuzzy set, vocabulary, if then rule, fuzzy inference system, and all. Okay, start with the what is fuzzy. So fuzzy means not clear, distinct, or precise. Mean not crisp value, and with unclear outline. What is meaning of fuzzy? Means not clear, distinct, or precise. Right. So one by one we clear what is fuzzy. So you can see here the one the graph is there. So the left side is a classical set, and the right hand side the B figure is fuzzy set. So classical set, normally an element either belong to or does not belong to a set that have been defined. Suppose I give one question, you have had breakfast, so you can give the two answer, yes or no. So there is the two value of your problem, so you can reply or give the answer in two way. But sometimes some question partially I have done, and partially the breakfast is remaining. Now how I have to represent this ambiguous word in our system, because the system is not understand this type of ambiguous word. So fuzzy set is an element belong to a partially or gradually to the set that have been defined. You can see here. So X belongs to neither to A nor B, and Y belongs to completely A. Then Z belongs to completely to B, and T belongs to partially to B. Sometimes this type of word are used, partially, exact, not exactly, near equal to, and all. So how we can represent this type of fuzzy or not crisp value? What is the meaning of crisp? The crisp is the exact value. Suppose I give the equation, what is the temperature now? So you can give the answer 23 degrees Celsius. So that is the crisp value of your problem. But sometimes you can say, I am not clear about what is exactly, but near equal to 25 degrees Celsius. So that is your fuzzy answer. Means now I have to take which value for my system. So you take the any 25 degree around, so you can take 23, 24, 26. So this is the fuzzy answer. So how the system can understand this type of fuzzy word? So that's why this fuzzy theory comes in picture. Okay, because the human are very intelligent. So they can take assumption any value regarding your problem, but the system can't understand your ambiguous word. So we require fuzzy theory. Okay, now clear? What is classical set? The classical set has some crisp value, means an element either belong or does not belong to a set that have been defined. But fuzzy has some partially or gradually to the set that have been defined. Now, what is fuzzy logic? So it has a two different meaning. As in narrow sense, fuzzy logic is a logic system which is an extension of multi-value logic. Means suppose you are using the Boolean logic, in that two answer is there, true or false, either 0 or 1. But sometimes in your problem there are the multi-value logic, so that's why we are using fuzzy logic. So fuzzy logic is a logical system which is an extension of multi-value logic. In a wider sense, fuzzy logic is almost synonym with the theory of fuzzy set, a theory which relate to the classical of object with unsharp boundary, in which membership is a matter of degree. Now we see what is the membership in fuzzy logic. So fuzzy logic should be interpreted in its wider sense. Okay. Now we take the more idea regarding fuzzy logic. A way to represent variation or imprecision in logic. So some imprecision or the fuzzy data we are represent using fuzzy logic. So a way to make use of a natural language in logic. Now you can see natural language we are converting into the system. So there is requirement of fuzzy logic. Because all the human are used different and different. Suppose I give the what is the height of this person. So you can say that near equal to this, their height is small. Now the word small is used, but how system can understand what is the value of small? So that's why natural language we have to convert into logic or the value. So that's why we are using fuzzy logics. Now it is the approximate reasoning. So already you have clear what is reasoning. So reasoning is the ability to learn your knowledge and give the action to your system. Because the first lecture, that is we are making an expert system that take decision automatically without help of human. So we are making a AI system. So the fuzzy logic is the based on the approximate reasoning. Why we are approximate the answer? Because the human normally use the natural language word. So that have not exact value. Sometimes they have give the ambiguous word. So we require fuzzy logic. So now I give the definition of fuzzy logic. A form of knowledge representation suitable for notations that cannot be defined precisely, but which depend upon their context. Okay. So their value is not defined precisely. Means we have not exact value, right? For, the height is 5.5. There is no height is given. So there is no value of your problem. That's why we are using fuzzy logic. Now, superset of conventional means logic that has been extended to handle the concept of partial truth, the truth values between completely true and completely false. That's why we are using fuzzy logic. Okay. Now the answer of your question, why use fuzzy logics? So conceptually easy to understand, that is flexible, tolerant of implicit data. Means you have not exact data or exact value of your problem. So that give the tolerant of imprecise data. Now FL can model nonlinear function of arbitrary complexity. FL can be built on the top of the experience of experts. FL can be blended with the conventional control technique, and FL is the based on the natural language. So fuzzy logic is our main purpose is used to represent your ambiguous word or the uncertain data in the logic in your system. So how we can give the system to input so that it take the decision, but we are using natural language. So that's why some different value can all the human have vary with their word. So that's why we are using fuzzy logic. Okay, now clear what is fuzzy logic and what is CRISP logic and why we use fuzzy logic. Now we take one example so you have more clear the concept of fuzzy logic. Now you can see that in classical theory, suppose I have one bike. Suppose I give the speed is equal to zero, then I can say that the bike and the speed is slow. And sometime speed is equal to one, then I can say that the bike speed is fast. Okay. Now, when comes the fuzzy set in picture, suppose some person say that this is the slowest, slow, fast and fastest. These are the words that are used to represent the ambiguity. Now these all are the word mostly used by the human. Now how we can convert this word into value? Because the system only work on the binary data and the numeric data. They can't understand the human word. Suppose I give this is the slowest bike. So what is the value of slowest? So I have to define what is the value between 0 to 0.25, then the bike speed is slowest. Now, what is the value of a slow? That is 0.25 to 0.50. This is my fuzzy set. I define fuzzy set. Now, fast. So, 0.50 to 0.75. So, So I give a specify a range, that is the my speed is fast. And what is the value of fastest? So if the range between 0.75 to 1, then the bike speed is fastest. So I have to define this all the terms and their value in our system. Because these are the ambiguous words, so system can't understand. So you can see the example of your fuzzy set. So first, what we are doing in before fuzzy set theory, so only we have our two options, slow and fast. And in fuzzy set, we have the four categories. Slowest, slow, fast, and fastest. So I have specified the range of your fuzzy set. Okay. This is the square bracket used to represent your interval of your fuzzy set. And what is the value, maximum value of fuzzy set? That is the one. That is the one value is the maximum value of your fuzzy set, and the minimum value is zero. So your fuzzy set value possible 0 to 1. Okay. Now we take one example so you have a more clear the concept of fuzzy set. So theory of fuzzy set, theory which relate to the classical of object with unsub boundary in which membership is matter of degree. Now the new word is come, that is what is membership, right? First, every problem can be presented in term of a fuzzy set. So a set without crease. So fuzzy set describe the vague concept. Fuzzy set admit the possibility of partial membership in it. So degree of an object belong to fuzzy set is denoted by membership value between 0 to 1. Now, what is membership value? So here you can see that the fastest speed of your bike is maybe suppose 0.785. So that is the membership of membership value of your set, the fuzzy set. So the degree, what is membership function? So you can see membership function, degree of an object belong to a set is denoted by membership value between 0 to 1. So how your object belong to your fuzzy set, this is the value of membership. Okay. So degree of an object belong to fuzzy set is denoted by membership value between 0 to 1. Now what is membership function? So membership function is associated with a given fuzzy set, maps an input value to its appropriate membership value. So membership function that convert your ambiguous word in the fuzzy set using membership value. Means what is the value of your object that belong to in your fuzzy set. Suppose I give one example. Here I have a speed that is 0.35. This is my membership value of your bike speed in this fuzzy set. So membership value is the degree of your object belong to a fuzzy set. Okay. Now you have clear the concept of this new word membership. Membership, membership function, and the fuzzy set. Now the different terms that are used in the letter theory. So we clear what is linguistic variable. So the variable whose value are words or sentence rather than number. So you can see already in example the different value of your word, that is slowest, slow, fast, and fastest. So these are the word that is called as a linguistic variable. So linguistic whose value are words or sentence rather than numbers. Now it represents quality spanning a particular spectrum. Suppose example, speed, service, tip, temperature. Suppose temperature has a different linguistic variable. So temperature is high, cold, hot, so low. So these are the different words that are used instead of your temperature. So these are the linguistic variable regarding your temperature. Okay. So what is linguistic value or term? So value or terms used to describe the linguistic variable. So here the linguistic word are slowest, slow, fast, and fastest are the linguistic word. And their value is 0 to 0.25, 0.25 to 0.50, 0.50 to 0.75, and 75 to 1. This is the linguistic variable value. Okay. Now, example for speed, you are using slowest, slow, fast, and fastest. For services, so you can use the poor, good, excellent. For temperature, you are using freezing, cool, warm, and hot. Right? So these are your linguistic variable. Okay, clear? Anyone have question, you can ask me. You can ask your question in chat box also, okay? All the student understand what is fuzzy logic, what is the linguistic variable and all. If you have any question, then you can ask me, okay? Now, one by one we see, what is the universal set of your fuzzy logic? So, universe of disclosure or universe or input space. So, set of all possible elements that can come into consideration confirm the set U in one. So, what is the value of universal set in fuzzy logic? The value of universal set is 1. So, maximum value of fuzzy logic is 1. And it depends on the context. And the elements of a fuzzy set are taken from the universe set of disclosure. An application of the universe is to suppress the faulty measurement data. Set of x greater than 1 would have a universe of all the real number, alternatively all positive integer. Now, what is this theory? That is, the maximum value of your universal set is 1. So all the fuzzy value is belongs to your 0 to 1. So 1 is maximum and 0 is the lowest value of your fuzzy set. What represent 1? Means your set is completely involved in your fuzzy set. Means the 1 is the given the complete involvement. And what is the 0 meaning? So there is the set is not belong to your fuzzy set. That is the value of 0. Okay? Now, there are the different membership functions are used in fuzzy logic. The membership function is a curve that defines how each point in the input space is mapped to a membership value between 0 and 1. So, what is the use of membership function? Suppose you are giving one example to solve your problem. So, how you can define the value? So, membership function is a curve that defines how each point in the input space is mapped to a membership value between 0 to 1. Now, it is denoted by mu sign. This mu sign is used to represent your membership function. So, membership value is also called as a degree of membership. Means, what is the involvement of your value in your fuzzy set? Okay? So, types of different membership function, that is, piecewise linear function, Gaussian distribution function, sigmoid curve, quadratic and cubic polynomial curve. These all are the different curve that is used to represent your space in the membership value. Okay? So, singleton membership function. There are the lots of membership function are available in fuzzy set. Okay? Now, I give the best graph so you have more clear the concept of fuzzy and the membership function. All are visible this graph. All are visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So what is membership function? So here you can see the x-axis, I have show the height of a person in meter. And this is your mu is a membership function, right? So, what is the involvement of your value in your fuzzy set? That is the membership function. X bar is the represented data in height in meter, and the y is your membership function involvement. Now, I have represent the height in three parts, small, medium, and tall. Why we are using fuzzy? Because these are the ambiguous words that the system can't understand the value of this word. Small, medium, and tall. So we have to give the value of this word. So here you can see that I define the interval. If the height of person is in between 0 to 1.6, then the user is the small. Then, if the height of person is 1.60 to 1.80, then the user is belongs to a medium class height. If the height is between 1.8 to 2 meter, then the user belongs to a tall height class. Okay, so I have defined the three classes: small, medium, and tall. And I also given the range of your height: 0 to 1.60, 1.60 to 1.80, and 2. Now you can see the graph. If also I can possible the graph directly straight line. You can see, suppose I have to draw this way. Why we are why I have draw this curve line? Anyone can tell me? You can see that this line is in curve shape. Why I am not drawing exact straight line? So this is the main concept of your fuzzy logic. Anyone can define why I not draw straight line? Small here 1 to 1.6 and then 1.6 to 1.80 and 1.80 to 2. Why I draw this cow shape?
Because in fuzzy logic the values are gradually changing, that's right.
Yeah, so exactly right answer. Suppose I give the height 1.59. So you can categorize in which class. Suppose I give the 1.59 and suppose I give the 1.61. So you can categorize in which class, small or medium, 1.59. So you can see that if the height of person is between 0 to 1.60, then the class is small. But the 1.59 is mostly near equal to 1.61, right? This is your medium class of your height. So in fuzzy logic, you are change the value gradually, not direct or certain thing. Because the height of a person is 1.61 is near equal to 1.59. So that's why I draw this curve. Because suppose I give an example, I take one value of 1.79 and 1.81. They are mostly near equal to 180. Now the class are different. Only 2.2 is difference between medium and tall. So that's why I change the value gradually. Because sometimes you can say that their height is near equal to tall. Tall class, right? So this word is a fuzzy logic system. So that's why we are using this graph in your fuzzy system. We are not change or make the straight line in your representation of your fuzzy value. Okay, now I hope you have clear. Now what is membership? Suppose I have the value that is the 0.7, so I can represent the user height membership value in fuzzy set is 0.7. So the class is small, and the what is the involvement of your height in your fuzzy set, that is 0.7. okay, so membership function represent the object involvement in your fuzzy set. So you can see that the 0.3, then 0.7 means that is the object or involvement in your fuzzy set. Okay, this fuzzy set contain three class: small, medium, and tall. And I categorize into three type. Suppose directly I can say what is the height of your person, so small and tall. So you can also categorize into two type, but here they are categorized into three type: small, medium, and tall. Then I have to specify the interval of the value that belongs to your this class. Okay, so then the system can understand what is the value of your height and how we can take the their category in small, medium, or tall. Because the human has an intelligence, So human take a decision based on their height, but system can't understand this type of word, small, medium, and tall. So that's why we are using fuzzy logics. Because in real life problem, all the human would use this type of ambiguous word. Suppose you are saying bike speed is slow, fast, fastest, and all. So the system can't understand this type of natural language word. That's why we are requiring this fuzzy logic system. Okay, I hope you have cleared the concept of fuzzy logic. Now, how I have to represent in a fuzzy set. So I have take here, you can see A is equal to my fuzzy set. Here X is the element of X, and capital X is the universe of this clause, and the mu of X is a membership function of X in A. Okay. So how we can represent your value in fuzzy set using this method? So this is the syntax, or this is the format for represent your data in fuzzy set. A is a fuzzy set, X is an element of X, mu of A is a membership function of X in A, and the X is a universe of disclosure, means that value is 1. What is the value of universal set in fuzzy set? That is 1 value, means universal set. And X is the element of X, and mu is the involvement of the membership function of X in A. Okay, clear? How we can represent our fuzzy set? This is the basic syntax for your represent your data. Now we take one example, so you have clear how can represent your data. Okay, fuzzy set theory provides a means of representing uncertainty. Fuzzy set theory uses linguistic variable rather than quantitative variable to represent imprecise concept. Now, we take one example so you have clear. CRISP set has a unique membership function. You can see mu is a membership function of your set A, right? So that has the 1 and 0 value. Suppose you can say that the height is small or tall. So tall is 1 and the small is 0. So this is your CRISP set. Now what is the fuzzy set? So fuzzy set can have infinite number of membership function. So you can directly represent the value of your membership function of set A belongs to 0 to 1. 0 is the minimum and the boundary is 1, that is the maximum value of your membership function. Now, you see this, the number is close to 5, so you can representation 4, 5 and 6. What is the value of CRISP? Suppose you are saying the 1, so directly you can draw the 1. But why we are using fuzzy? Some not unique and task dependent and user data. So you are change the value like 4, 5, 6. So in interval between 4 to 6, then you can represent your data in this manner. Means that have not exact value, okay? Here, you take one example. Suppose I give he or she is tall. So the value of your tall is either 0 or 0 for small and tall for the 1. So you can represent in this manner. But in fuzzy system, you have to represent your data in this manner. Already I have explained the curve. Because the fuzzy value is gradually changed, okay? Push the brake slightly. Okay, sometimes the ambiguous words are used, so we can represent in this manner. Now, what is classical set? So, define a universe of disclosed X as a collection of objects all having the same characteristics. The individual element in universe X will be denoted as X. The feature of the element X can be discrete or continuous value quantity on the real line. Example of element of various universe might be as follow. The clock speed of your computer CPU. The operating current of the electronic motor. The operating temperature of a heat pump. The integer 1 to 10. So classical set has the crisp value, that is integer value, 1 to 10 and all, right? So there are the different operation you already study. We are directly perform this union, intersection, complement, difference, all the operation in classical set. You can see A union B is equal to X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Then intersection were directly performed. X belongs to A and X belongs to B. And the complement means X not belongs to A. So X is a given universal set. If you have to find complement, then you can, 1 minus, you can represent your data. So this is the complement of your universal set. And also you can find the difference between A and B. So A belongs to A and X not belongs to B. This is the operation on your classical set. Same as it is, we are performing the operation in fuzzy system. So this is the graphical representation of this classical set. So union of set A and B. So you can use all the part of A set and the B set. So intersection means you can only same content of A and B set are used. Okay. Here you can see that the A and B has some part are same. So you can only use this data. So complement is the given universal set you have to minimize from your set. This is your complement set. And what is the difference operation, that is A minus B, means X belongs to A but X does not belongs to B. That is your difference operation in a classical set. Now, these are the rule you have already know in mathematics. A union B is equal to B union A. A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. So you can directly also solve this using this formula. A union A is equal to A. A intersection A is equal to A. A union X. X is your universal set is equal to A. Then the X. Then A intersection X is equal to A. A union phi is equal to A. A intersection phi is equal to phi. These are the operation we require in real life system. So these are the operation performed on classical set. Now, mapping of classical set into function. So I have some value. So how I can represent or convert in the function? So mapping is an important concept in relating set theory form of function theory representation of information. In its most general form, it can be used to map element or subset in one universe of disclosed to element or set in another universal. Means you have a value 1 and 0, so you can make a function. So how you can convert your set into function? So I make one function, that is X. So X of X is equal to 1 and 0. So if X belongs to A, then the value is 1. If X does not belongs to A, then the value of 0. Okay? So in this manner, you can represent your classical set into function. Now, what is fuzzy set? So fuzzy set is a set containing element that have the varying degree of membership in set. So element in a fuzzy set, because their membership need to not be complete, can also be member of the other fuzzy set on the same universe. So element of a fuzzy set are mapped to a universe of membership value using function theoretical form. So you can take one example. So how we can represent our data in a membership function in fuzzy set? If U is a collection of objects denoted by generally by X, then a fuzzy set A in U is defined as a set of ordered pair. You can see A is equal to X, comma, membership function of A in X, then X belongs to universal set. So what is the degree of or the value of membership function of A? So directly that belongs to universal set 0 to 1. This is a representation of fuzzy set. Okay, so classical function x indicating the belongingness of x to the set A. So suppose you have to find the operation of A union B. So this is the formula, means maximum of A value comma B. So x of x is your function, that is your function, that that value is 1 and 0. So you have to find the A union B. So this is the formula for maximum value of x, membership value of x, A comma membership value of B set. So you can find the A union B in fuzzy set. Then you can find the minimum value using min function. So you have given the two set A and B. Now you have to find the A intersection B. So minimum of membership value of A set comma membership value of B. Suppose you have find the complement of A. So 1 minus membership value of A in the set A. Suppose you are finding double complement. So directly that is the value of original set A. So these all are the operation performed in fuzzy set. So these are the formula for fuzzy set operation. So you can find the A union B, A intersection B, then the complement of your set. Then you can also use the Morgan's law in the fuzzy set theory. So A union A dash not equal to X. A intersection A is not equal to phi in fuzzy set operation. Okay. So this is your graphical representation of A union B. So A set and the B set totally cover this all the value, that is A union B. And A intersection B, so only the same value of A and B set.